me to show you the way. I feel sorry for you, so I'll lead you there just this once. Don't forget how to get there, and try to keep up. Okay, this is the divine barrier. Use the beetle key to open the beetle gate. Duh. The beetle gate is the one to the far right. From there on out, it's all up to you.
Who are you? I've seen poachers who impersonate cocoon masters. If you are a real cocoon master, show me by playing that flute. Slowly now. Are you the son of Riquettes, the cocoon master of Cyrus? If the son of Riquettes has been sent into the forest, the village must be in danger. Tell me what has happened in Cyrus. I see. So the Onibubu have reached Cyrus as well. And you came to search for the Calabas herb, huh? You're flute playing. You don't know anything yet, do you? Your father would never forgive me if I just let you go into the forest to die. I am Chorus, the Blue Cocoon Master. On behalf of my comrade Riquettes, I shall initiate you to the arts of the Cocoon Master. The minions of the forest are full of melancholy, and are thus very dangerous. It is our task to capture them, but first, they must be weakened. It is for this purpose only that you would attack with a weapon. Let's have you learn the basics by actually fighting a minion. Have you any mugwort herb? Here we go. attacking is the most important technique in battle. Continue to battle while restoring your strength as long as you still have mugwort herbs. However, if you run out of mugwort and your health is running low, then it is better to retreat than defend. These are the basic rules of combat. But remember, the mission of the Cocoon Master is not to kill, but to soothe souls. No matter how furious or violent a minion may be, you must not kill. Killing will bring you nothing. Good job. Take this as a symbol of your hard work. Simply trapping a minion in a cocoon will not soothe its spirit. It requires purification. If you are a cocoon master, you must have taken a Nagi woman as your bride in the sacred union. Have your wife purify a firefly cocoon. It will then become a white cocoon. Once it becomes a white cocoon, you can summon the minion into battle. The sound of your flute shall soothe the minion's souls. Trapping them in empty cocoons is known as capturing. Let's have you learn the basics by fighting a minion. Here we go. Your success with capturing depends on your skill with the flute. And the only way to improve is to imprison as many minions as you can. You won this time because I used a weak minion. In reality, you won't have it so easy. Train hard and work on your flute playing. In time, capturing minions will become easier for you. You can only carry so many empty cocoons with you. Each time a capture fails, you lose one. It would be wise to return to the village if you run out. The minion you just captured is my gift to you. However, it is useless until it is purified. Magic beasts gain strength through victory in battle. And by merging different beasts together, they will become even stronger. Try it once you have obtained a few. Your wife shall merge them for you. Be warned that while merging does pass on characteristics of both beasts, elemental properties and special abilities can either be strengthened or weakened. This is the one thing I cannot teach you. You must master this process yourself. We are called Cocoon Masters because we have the power to summon magical minions. In order to beckon these minions, we must translocate our earthly vessels. In other words, the minions fight in our stead. Mesmerized by the sound of the flute. After all, We are but beasts of knowledge, no match for the minions deep in the forest. That means we must fight minion with minion. However, you may only take 3 magical beasts with you at a time. Each minion possesses 1 of 4 distinct elemental properties. Keep the following relationships in mind. Earth repels water. Water extinguishes fire. Fire eliminates air, and wind whittles away earth. Know your opponent and develop a strategy first. Simply trap. Once it. Very well. Now, you must try to apply what you have learned. My cottage is deep inside this forest. If you arrive there safely, you shall receive my approval. Oh, son of the Lion of Peril, you shall become a cocoon master worthy of your father's name.
don't overdo it until you get better at hunting, all right? Try talking with Mother Garai if there's something you don't understand. But I'd watch out. Her stories can be long and boring. But don't tell her I said that. Our enemy we love, and for the tormented we pray. Grant us, the beasts of knowledge, the power to touch the spirit. O magical beasts who serve us, merge thy flesh to gain yet greater power. Reveal to us thy heroic form. O magical beasts who serve. Thank you. Well, good luck. I'll always be here if you need anything.
Ever since your father disappeared into the forest, Corus has been taking very good care of Cyrus. However, he promised to do so only until you came of age. I think it would be best for you to study under him. Black cocoons are the cocoons of ruin. They are cocoons that do not belong in this world. The difference between black and white cocoons lies in their method of purification. Purification by a Nagi woman yields a white cocoon. But if a man purifies one, it will become a black cocoon which will bear an evil, dark beast. The Nagi man who purified it shall become possessed by the black cocoon and be transformed into a beast. Everything a black cocoon touches is reduced to ruin, even the cocoon master. The black cocoon is the ruin of people's hearts. You must never give in to their dark powers. Empty cocoons are normal silkworm cocoons. They have not been changed in any way. Capturing your prey into empty cocoons is the foundation of the cocoon master hunting technique. But fierce minions cannot be imprisoned right away. First, you must weaken them and pacify their spirit. That is where your swordsmanship comes into play. Once you have weakened them, play your flute. When the minion hears your melody, its spirit will seek tranquility and thus become captured in the cocoon. Cocoons that contain an imprisoned minion are known as firefly cocoons. A firefly cocoon is a cocoon in which a minion has been captured, but do not be deceived by its beautiful glow. It has only been captured, not tamed. Its curse has by no means been removed. In this state, you cannot summon the minion within nor spin it into silk. If a villager tries to spin a firefly into silk, they shall be doomed to die by its curse. Removing the curse requires purification by the divine magic of my people, the Nagi. Once purified, a firefly cocoon becomes a white cocoon. You can use the magic beast by summoning it from a white cocoon. Summon the magic beast to fight in your stead by playing your flute. The power of a summoned beast shall far exceed your swordsmanship. Every divine beast is composed of one of four elements: fire, water, earth, and air. True cocoon master has a good command of these elements. Also remember that white cocoons can also be spun into fine silk thread. Minions that you capture in the forest are merely imprisoned in cocoons. A firefly cocoon is of no use to you as is. You may neither use it for profit nor release the spirit imprisoned within. You must first ask Mabu to purify it in order to cleanse the spirit within. Cleansed firefly cocoons become white cocoons. You will find the tame minions to be very useful. Purification is the work of a Nagi woman who has wed a cocoon master. Releasing the spirits is not your work alone. It is to be done by both of you. That was soon after I left the Nagi village with Mabu, who was yet an infant. I came across a wounded man laying collapsed on the ground. He was a cocoon master. He was gravely wounded, but my treatment revived him. The man thanked me and produced a flute from his pocket. He said that he wished me to deliver it to his son in Cyrus. Then he disappeared into the depths of the forest, just like that. That man was your father, Riketz, also known as the Lion of Peril. And so it was our fate to settle down and live here in Cyrus. Perhaps this too was the will of Elrum, God of the Forest. Well, you should be off now. Oh, please, do be careful.
Your father promised me that one day he would solve the mystery of purification. He was the first person to be kind to me, a Nagi woman. Take care. I will always be praying for you.
themselves as cocoon masters to poach game here. You may be one of them. We must find out whether or not you're the real thing.
Thank you.
So, the son of the Lion of Peril is even more talented than I had thought. I looked up the Calabas herb in my books, but in the end, I found nothing. However, there is a folk tale that describes a dust that wakes the sleeping. It is the story of a wondrous powder kept by a half-bird, half-man named Kikinak, who lives in the Dragonfly Forest. Perhaps that powder is brewed from the Calabas leaves. This is only a guess, and it's all I could find. But I think it is worth looking into. Here is the key to the Dragonfly Gate. You should have it. Better head straight back to the village and consult with Garai. She may know something about the tale of Kikinak. You must do your best before it is too late.